morning, students.
Good morning.
How are you? Today we are going to discuss the topic of test unit, that is linked types of linked list and the difference between array and linked list. As far as we have discussed about array is a homogeneous data structure, and continuous memory allocations are there in array. Now we are going to deal with linked list. What is linked list? First of all, in this lecture we will learn about linked list, which is a part of data structure. In which data structure? It is a linked data structure. And before that, the second topic will be data structure and possible operations on data structure. In this we will learn how many types of data structures are there and what are the different types of operations we are going to deal with the data structure. Different types of data structure and its because the significance in every field. And then after we will go to discuss with the linked list, types of linked list and then after operations on linked list. There are seven different kinds of operations which can be performed on any data structure. These operations are: the first operation which can be understood as traversal. We have to access each and every element of the data structure at least once. And data structure is what? Data structure is a organization of data into a certain environment, and we have to organize data depend upon the requirement. If we have to store the data in a sorted form, then we have to apply some different type of data structure. And if we want a continuous data to be stored, then we apply the different data structure, that is array. So depend upon the requirement of the user, the data structure is built upon the requirement. So the operations which are included in the data structure operations are: first is traversal. In the traversal of any data structure, or we can say in this context linked list, what is traversal? We have to access each and every element of the data structure at least once. It is only for the displaying the linked list elements. And the second operation is insertion of any data element into the data structure, that is insertion. We have to add some data depending upon the requirement of the user. It can be inserted at the beginning, it can be inserted at the end of the data structure, or it can be inserted after a given element in the data structure. We will take some more examples regarding this. The third operation is deletion of any element from the data structure, that is removal of any data element in the data structure. It can be removed, the data can be removed from the beginning, from the end, from a given position, or we have to firstly search the data and then after we have to delete it. That these four operations are there in the data structure in the deletion part. The fourth operation which can be done on data structure is updation. If you want to update any element, the content of any element in the data structure, the content can be updated by searching only, and for searching we have to traverse that element whose value we have to change. And then fifth number in the operations on data structure is insertion, deletion, updation, sorting. We have to sort any data in ascending or descending order. And then the sixth operation is searching. If you want to search a given element in data structure, we have to traverse it as whole, and we have to traverse it till the element is found or not. It depends upon the position of data. And then 7 here is margin. Margin is we have to combine the two data structure, and we have to combine these two data structure, and we have to build a new data structure, the combination of these two data structures. Okay, and then after the types of English, in the types of English we will going to study the four types of English. The first is single English, that is single English, which is linked. The data elements are in the data elements are linked by only one pointer, that is single English. Second is double English, and third is single circular English. And the fourth one is doubly circular linked. The basic difference between the linked list and the array is the array stores the element in a continuous memory location, but in case of linked list, we have to store the element by its address only, and the link to the data elements will be followed by a pointer. It will be done by a pointer, that is the data element, the data will be stored in a node. The node contains two threads. First is the element, means the data part, and the second is the link part. We can also write it as data part, and second is link part. Means this part will link to the next element which we are going to insert in the data structure, that is linked list. In the linked list, the memory consumption is very efficient. While in case of array, the memory consumption is not so efficient, because if we want to insert only two elements in a group of in an array of 100 elements, then 90 spaces will be used, and it will not know any use, because the elements which we are going to insert will consume only 4 bytes, and 90 and the remaining 98 multiplied by 2 bytes will be of no use in the array. So in the linked list, we have to in the linked list, we will have the efficient memory utilization. Now, as far as we discussed operation on linked list, the operations are insertion, deletion, traversal, all these kind of operations we are going to study. Now, the main topic of study is the operation on linked list. So, we were in discussion that we have to discuss that traversal and linked list. We have to discuss this traversal before we are going to have some basic overview of linked list, how to traverse an element. Suppose this is a linked list that contains these elements. The two parts, the first part is the data part. We have to insert, suppose the whole number we have to insert is 2, 5, 7, 8, these are the elements, okay? And the node where these elements are stored, the address of the node is, suppose 1000, it is having 777, and it is 2000, it is 2500. These are the memory addresses of the element which we have to store in this linked list. Suppose the first element we are going to insert is 2. So the link part of this node will contain the address that is 777. Means the memory address which is linked to the next element we have to insert the memory address of the next element in the first row. Okay, same as row number 5 is to be inserted. Now here the address will be, the address to be inserted will be the next, will be the address of the next node in the label, that is 2000. Now we have to insert, that is 7, and here the address will be 2500, and the next element we will insert is 8. We have to remember that the last address will be represented as a null address in the linkage. Now if we have to traverse this kind of linkage, we should need a pointer that is named as start pointer, which the pointer will contain the starting address of that element, of the first node of the element from where we have to traverse that. In the case of array, if we have the first node, if we have the address of the first node, we can search any node, or we can select any random address because the memory addresses are 4 digits. While in case of linkage, we are seeing that the random address has been given to the node of the linkage. So we have to start with a pointer field, that is the start pointer, which is having the address same as the address of first node. So for traversing it, for displaying the roll number list, that is 2, 5, 7, 8 and so on, we have to first of all write a function for that. I can say that the function will be display list. The function is named at display list. Now the parameters here are, we do not have to give any node or roll number. We have to simply display the list over here. So but for that, the starting address of the element should be given. So we will give the input parameter as start pointer, that is struct student asterisk star. So this is the input parameter, and here we will write the return type of that function. The function should return what? The function is not going to return any value because the value is not being updated. The start, if the value of the start is being updated, we have to write here as int or something else. So here the function will not return anything, so it will come as void. Now we have to move from one pointer, one address to another address. So we have to make a temporary variable. We have to define a temporary variable that is named as pointer, that is PTR. So the PTR value is of struct student type. So we will declare it as struct student asterisk PTR to traverse the linkage from one node to another node. And here in this case, we will also assign the start value into the value of PTR so that we can traverse it easily. How do we traverse? We will apply a loop while PTR not equals to none. And then in the while loop, we will going to display the roll number. So for displaying the roll number, we have to apply this statement, that is printf, and printf here will be the roll number equals to %d, and here what the roll number is here. So and then after, the value of PTR will be updated after displaying the roll number 2, and it will be updated as the next memory address of the labels. So here we will write PTR equals to PTR's Next address. As far as the room will be running. So here, in the first case, the address of PTR will be same as 1000, because we can observe here that we are saying the value of start in PTR. So the value of PTR will be 1000. And if you see in the next statement, in the while loop where PTR value is not equal to that, if I would ask you that PTR, the value of PTR is 1000, and then 1000 is not equal to that, the condition is true, because the PTR is not equal to 1000, that is, the statement is same. So the roll number will be displayed, that is, roll number equals to percent D, and it will display as PTR roll part. PTR roll part. And the roll number is an integer, so the SS specifier will be percent. And then after, the value of PTR will be updated by the next address. And the loop continue until the statement is will be false. And the statement will be false at the last element, which is 8 here in this case, and the value of PTR will be none of them, and then the statement will exit. And here the traverser is over. We have displayed the whole linked list elements of the linked list in the order in which they are arranged. As far as we have discussed the operation in the data structure, and the second is traversal. And now we will deal with the insertion of linked list. It is defined in three cases. The first is insertion at the beginning of the linked list. Here we have to insert a given node, that is, let us say 1, the roll number 1 is to be inserted at the beginning. It is a temporary node, and we have to insert in the linked list as a permanent node. So the cases can be three. First is insertion at beginning. Second case can be insertion at the end. The third case could be insertion after a given, that is considered as insertion after given element. We will be given an element after which we have to insert that particular element. So there can be three cases insertion at the beginning. So now, first thing we will do the insertion at the beginning is here the name of the function we can write as insert begin. There will no any embedded space in these two words. Then we will going to discuss about the parameters which they are, which this function is having. First, we have to, if you want to insert any element in the at the beginning, we must know the starting address of the linked list. So here instruct student asterisk start is the starting address of the linked list, and we do not require any roll number. Yes, we require a roll number which is to be inserted at the list. So the second argument will be int roll. Okay, these are the two arguments, and the header type of this function will be student. Okay, so now we are going to insert an element. If you want to insert any element at the beginning, we have to make this temporary node. So for making this temporary node, we have to make a pointer, that is lamp, and which is of student type. The temp pointer we have to make a node of wires for roll number and two wires for the length part. So we have to make a storage space of four wires. So we will make a statement over there. Tan equals to struck student mellow size of struck student. This line itself signifies that if we want to make a node, a blank node of the size struck student, means the size of 4, we have to call a mellow function which will create a blank node, and it will be defined as temp over here. And in this temp pointer, we have to insert the element temp roll equals to the roll number which we are giving as a input in this function. So at the roll part of temp, it will have suppose 1. And now this temp part is to be inserted at the beginning. So for this, what we have to do, we have to make the connections. And initially, the temp next part will be set as null. Okay, there is no address. But if you want to insert and connectify this temp node, we have to connect this from the next element address. So the element of the next address will be 1000. Suppose the address of temp is 999. Here it is. So in the temp, in the next part of temp, what we have to insert is the start, the address of start, because start is already pointing to the first node, and it will become the second node after it is inserted. So to rectify it, we have to insert the memory address of the first node, that is start, in the temp's next part. So in the temp's next part, we will place the value of start, and now it is going to connect with this one. And what property does the start is having? The start will always connect with the first node where the start will always contain the address of first node. And here in this case, the first node will be temp. So it will going to point the address of the node, that is temp, and the address of node is 999. So we have to fill start as start equals to temp, so that the value of start will be updated. And if in any case, if the value of start is being updated, what we have to do, that we have to apply the struct student string our there as a return type element, as a return type, because the return type of the start is the struct student type, means the return type of the start is a structure. Now the next topic is insertion after a given element. Suppose we have to we have assigned some element which is to be inserted after a specific element in the linked list. So wherein, suppose this is a linked list of three elements. The first element is 2nd, 3, 7, these are the roll numbers, and the address of the nodes are, suppose it can be taken as any random address. Now if we want to insert any element, say 4, if you want to insert the roll number 4 after the specific element which is represented as SR. If you want to insert this roll number 4, after this roll number, what process we are going to adopt a insertion after a given element in the list. So what we have to do? First, we have to make some function. The function name can be given as insertion after given. In the insertion after given, I want to ask you that if we are going to insert an element after some particular element, then the address will be changed or not? The starting address will be changed or not? It cannot be changed because it is inserted after some element. So the starting the address of the starting element will not be updated at all. So the return type will be only void because it is not going to return any updated value of the start. So now we are having the input parameter. What parameters we are going to have? The first parameter will be start, that is struct student asterisk start for traversing the elements of the list. Second, the searching roll number after which we have to insert the element. So the searching roll number will be the second argument. We can write it as INTSR, that is I have already given out there SR. It is, and the third variable will be the roll number which we have to add after the roll number, after the searching roll number, that is 3. We have to add this roll number 4 after the 3 roll number. So it will be another parameter, that is INT roll. So this is the function, how it is defined and how the return type is changed from struct student to void. The parameter is changed from struct student to void because in this case the addressing of start will not be updated. In any case, will not be modified in this case insertion after given. So now we have to make this statement mode, that is temp. We will declare it as temp. So here in this case we will have to make two pointer of struct student type struct student as in PTR. For the PTR is for traversing the node and to reach at the particular node we have to traverse the node, that is with the help of PTR. And the second is node will be asterisk temp. The temp node is for the creation of a brand node which will contain the address of, which will contain the two parts. First is the node part, data part, and the second is the link part. So the temp will be defined as struct student asterisk mellow size of struct student. From this statement we will create this blank node which is termed as temp. And in this temp part, in this temp pointer, at the place of temp's role part, we have to insert the roll number which we have indicated as input parameter in the function. So in the temp role part, suppose we inserted the roll number 4. In the temp next part, by default we include the null pointer, means the ready-made node with the element 4 and the null part is being inserted over here. So now if you want to insert this node after a particular element, we have to traverse this element first. So for tracing this element we will require the PTR. The value of PTR will be copied from the value of start. So the PTR will now have 1000 because in the starting address it is represented as 1000. So the media, we will copy the value of star. And then we will place a condition of 5, loop of 5, a loop of 5, that is PTR, while PTR not equals to null, or second case, while PTR not equals to null, and in the PTR role, we note until we not find SR. Means these are the two conditions. If PTR not equals to null and PTR score is not equals to SR, if the condition is true, what we have to do, we have to traverse the limit. PTR equals to PTR next. Because we have to search until the element is not found. So by this, with the help of this proof, we can illustrate this case. If in the starting at the starting node, the value of PTR is 1000, let us say. 1000 is not equal to the condition is true. And the second condition is PTR in the lower part of PTR. In the lower part of PTR, the PTR is now pointing to the first node. In the lower part of PTR, what is written? 1. The lower part of PTR is 1. And what we have to search for? We have to search for 3. And 1 is not equal to 3. So it will enter the loop and it will update the address of PTR. And the address of PTR will be updated as PTR's next address. And the PTR next address is 1005 in this case. Now, after reaching to 1000, it will continue, the loop will continue until and unless we can search the element, that is 3. After having the element, the searching element as 3, we have to make the connection. We have identified that the searching element, we have find out, and then we have to connect these with the first we have to connect and from the right side of the linkage. First connection we have to do is search type. So here the address is 112, let us say, because it will point to the next address. So it is 112. What we have to do, we have to make one more statement over here, that is PTR equals to PTR. And here we will going to point one more pointer, that is PTR, which is contained the previous node or previous address of the node. So here in this case we will write PTR's next equals to PTR's next. What is it? PPTR next means PPTR. Here it is PPTR or PTR. It is PTR. So what we have to do in the PTR, in the PTR next, what is this? It is PTR. So we have to write this line of code as the as this one. Okay, so this is the name. What we want to do is we have to insert the address of PTR next. Yes, the address of PTR next will be assigned in the 10th next part. Which means first we have to make this one, this connection. For this connection, what we have to write is in the 10th next part. It will be replaced with PTR's next. And then the second connection will be with this node. It means PTR's next will be indicated by this name. So we will write here as PTR's next equals to 10. So we have rectified. We have made the node and insert it after a given element as specified in our topic. So we have done with the insertion of a given element. And in the next class, we will understand with. third part, that is insertion.